domestic waste, the waste that is generated due to the ordinary day-to-day use of a domestic premise, but most of the people do not dispose them correctly. A study of waste disposal behavior in Kuala Lumpur indicated that 31.9% of waste disposed by open burning, while 6.5% were dumped into the river system. It clearly shows that the domestic waste is polluting our water and air. To solve these situations, we are going to present to you the eco-friendly incinerator, which can turn your rubbish into 4% of its original size ashes without producing any harmful gases. The objective of this project is to reduce the area of landfill, control the hazardous gas production during waste management, compliance with the Environmental Quality Act, and give a new life to the waste disposed. After your rubbish is dumped into the incinerator, heating process happens when the plasma reactor produces magnetization airflow and a steady temperature of 200 to 400 degrees Celsius. It forms a negative pressure state of ionization in an enclosed chamber. Oxygen is allowed to flow in via a small opening. The heat breaks the bond in oxygen molecules, so reactive oxygen atoms are formed. Under the condition of closed magnetic heat effect, electrons accelerate from the separation of atom and interact with the nucleus, causing the formation of plasma state. The plasma state oxygen oxidizes organic matter completely.
Then, pyrolysis occurs as the electronic will infiltrate into the treated organic molecular chain. The carbon molecules chain will be torn by the electronic by taking organic hydrocarbon structure of hydrogen or by infiltrating into carbon molecules. The formation of pyrolysis fuel happens, causing the organic matter to be fully carbide and dispose the organic hazardous substances in a non-polluting way. However, the formation of soot, smoke, and ash happens when the combustion is incomplete. Besides, gases such as carbon monoxide and carbon dioxide are produced during pyrolysis.
After the waste has been pyrolyzed, the soot and the smoke produced will be filtered. The smoke is firstly passed through the deep bed system. In this system, the contaminated air first passes through pre-filters, which trap the suspended particles, and then through the required chemical media beds, which chemically destroy or retain any remaining gaseous impurities. Next, the gases are pumped and dissolved into the mixture of water and potassium hydroxide solution. The water scrubber system suppresses heavy metals, pollutants, dioxin, furan, and other harmful particles. In this way, we could also dissolve carbon monoxide and carbon dioxide gases in water to form carbon acid. The reaction of carbon acid with potassium hydroxide will produce potassium carbonate, an essential nutrient to fertilize an arable land. Last, the oil droplets and odor will be trapped and give a non-toxic and odorless vapor.
The incinerator is eco-friendly because there is no external energy required with the operation of a solar panel. Furthermore, it can achieve up to 95% of landfill diversion. The ashes produced are non-hazardous that can be used as fertilizer. The incinerator is a closed-loop system in which everything stops here and no secondary contamination will be generated. Last, it achieves green and zero pollution, as its products are only vapor and ashes.
In short, the eco-friendly incinerator is beneficial in terms of environment, finance, and operation. If this technology is well developed around the world, everyone will have an equal chance to live in a clean and beautiful environment.